Hey guys, welcome back to Technopedia. It's Sankit here again to continue HTML beginners course. So today we are going to discuss about frames in HTML, attributes of frame tag and the advantages and drawback of frame. So a frame page is actually made up of multiple HTML pages where all HTML pages are further linked with the master page, that is frame page. A frame tag is always placed under the head tag. So let's do code for the frames. Let's give the title lesson 11. So for designing frames, we first have to implement the frameset container, which is the paired tag. So what it does, the frameset tag create divisions in the browser window, and this allows us to divide either as rows or column. So let's talk about the attributes of frameset. The first attribute of frameset is rows, that specifies or determines the size and number of rows within a frameset. Let's suppose I want to divide a web page in 3 segments. Let's take an example of 25%, 50%, and again 25%. So here I want to create 3 frames. So I can use 3 frame tag. The frame tag is unpaired tag. Let's save it on desktop with the file name lesson11.html. So here you can see, let's open it. So these 3 frames were built, where first is of 25, second is of 50, and last one is of again 25. Now what if I want to divide the second frame into 2 columns? For this I simply use frame set again just after the one frame, where I use calls attribute for columns. And let's give size 50% each. For which I used to make 2 frames. And after 2 frame, let's close the frame set. Save it. And refresh the result. So here you can see the second frame is differentiated into 2 parts. Now let's talk about some other attributes of frame set. That is frame border, used to set the border of the frame. By default its value is 1, but if we set the value of frame border as 0, then what happens? The border of the frame will disappear. So let's remove it, or we can change it from 0 to 1. Again save it and refresh the result. So here you can see, in this way you can set the border of the frames. Now the other attribute is border color. Used to set the color of the border or frame. Let's suppose I want to set the color of the border, that is brown. Save it, refresh the result. So here you can see the border becomes brown in color. Now let's talk about the attribute of frames. The frame tag is also has its own attributes. So guys, here you can see I already made some files over here with the file name abcd, which I am gonna include in these frames. So the first attribute for frame is src, which is the source. Here we can give the source file. I gave a.html, where a.html is the file having the background color red. For the second frame, I gave b.html. For third one, c.html. And for the last one, b.html. So let's save it and refresh the result. So here you can see all the four files is included and appears as a frame. So let's talk about other attribute of frame, that is we can also give name to the frame in this way. Suppose I give one. The other attribute is scrolling. We can give its value as yes, no, or auto, where yes always display a scroll bar, no never displays a scroll bar, and if we give auto in it, then browser will decide based on the frame content. And there is one another attribute, that is no resize. It prevents user, or we can say viewers, from resizing the frame. And these attributes can be implemented in all of the frames. So in this way you can create your own frames. The main advantage of creating frames are we can embed more than one page into a single web page. But there are also some drawback of frame. The first one is frame are not search engine friendly. The second one is we cannot create responsive website using frames. BG color is not possible in frames. In frames we should have at least two HTML documents. And in frames also we have to link other HTML files for filling the content in a frame. But this drawback is overcome by using the concept of iframe, which I will be cover in the next tutorial, that is lesson 12. And I also want to show you something which I have made with the help of frame. So guys, here you can see, here I made three frames where I use marquee for this, news feeds, and scrolling by using the scroll bar. These are the links. If I click contact us, then the result will appear in the middle frame. And if I click the register link, then the form should come up in the middle page. This can be happened by using the name attribute for frames. So that's all for today. If you guys find this stuff is helpful for you, then give thumbs up, ask question in the comment section down below. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for upcoming lessons. Hope we'll meet again with the new things. Bye for now. Keep learning and keep practicing.